Hi, I'm Natalie Baker, licensed psychotherapist and certified neurofeedback trainer. And if you've been doing research on brain training devices, you've probably noticed the market has exploded over the last few years with so many options out there. You might be wondering, you know, what's the best brain training device? And the short answer is it totally depends on your goals and your budget. But what we're going to do in this video is we're going to break it down so that you can make an informed decision and not waste your time and money on the wrong device. So first off, it's important to know that terms like brain training and neurofeedback are unregulated. So this means that anything, any device can call itself a brain training device, from simple apps to clinical grade systems. You'll see there's a lot of things that are called neurofeedback. So the market is flooded with options, which on the one hand is great, but it also means you need to be extra careful about what you invest your time and money in. So how do you choose? Let's start with your goals. Are you looking for a little extra help relaxing? Are you trying to recover from a head injury or something that's also bigger, like long-term stress or emotional dysregulation? Your answer to this question is going to guide your decision. So for under $300, around that range, you can find a headband style neurofeedback device. These are consumer products. They typically work by nudging your brain into certain brainwave frequencies, like those associated with relaxation. So if your goal is to get a little gentle encouragement in that direction, you know, these can be fine. But remember, when it comes to the brain, you often get what you pay for. Your brain is a very sophisticated device itself. You can think of it as like a big computer. So those systems aren't designed to make significant lasting changes. They're more like a light nudge than a full-on training program. So if you're recovering from a head injury or trying to address and support some mental health symptoms or really want to, you know, upgrade your ability to focus, this requires more of an investment in terms of time and money. So clinical grade neurofeedback systems like the one I use are designed to really help the brain to create lasting changes. So these systems are particularly effective for resetting ingrained habits, managing stress-related issues, improving your focus and executive functioning. So yes, they are a bigger investment for sure. But if you're serious about gaining traction on deep-seated challenges, they're worth it. And so I want to talk a little bit about sleep because for many years I've helped people with sleep. And many people look to a brain training device to improve their rest. But here's the truth. For better sleep, you should start with good sleep hygiene. So this doesn't cost a dime, but it does require effort and consistency. So that looks like kind of like, you know, teaching a child to go to bed well. We're teaching ourselves to go to bed at a consistent time, to limit screens before bed. One thing I really recommend is trying a relaxation, a guided one. You can find yoga nidra videos on YouTube. They're great and they're really effective at calming the nervous system, getting you out of that go, you know, thinking mode and into your body, into relaxation mode. So what's the best brain training device? It really depends on your goals. If you're curious and you want to just dip your toes in, a $300 headband might work well for you. But if you're looking for real transformation, you need to look at the clinical grade neurofeedback systems. And so whatever you choose, I encourage you to take your time, do your research, set realistic expectations. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'm more than happy to help you navigate this exciting and growing field and for you to improve your health. So thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. We're going to have lots more videos with brain training tips.